Good day, everyone!
I am Adolfo Christopher A. Nimes.
And I am Stephanie A. Cortez.
And today we're going to discuss
the Chapter 1,
The Advent of a National Hero.
Again, good day everyone. So first, let's discuss the birth of our national hero. So his complete name is Jose Protasio Mercado y Alonso Rialonda, was born in Calamba, Laguna on June 19 in the year 1861 near midnight. So he was died and executed at the Luneta, Manila on December 30, 1896. So clearly, he had lived for 35 years, no? So going back on the birth of our national hero, nung ipinanganak daw si Dr. Jose P. Rizal ay nasabing halos mamatay ang kanyang ina dahil sa panganak kasi nga daw malaki yung ulo niya. So moving on, so up to this day, di ba meron tayong, we have this old custom, Filipino custom. So yung mama niya, si Teodora Alonso Rialonda, named our national hero or her newborn baby, Jose, in honor of San Jose or Saint Joseph, the father of Jesus Christ. So, 3 days after nung ipinanganak si Dr. Jose Rizal, he was baptized at the Catholic Church of Calamba by Father Rufino Colyantes. So, si Father Rufino Colyantes, yun yung parish priest doon sa simbahan ng Calamba. His ninong or godfather, kung sa atin pa in Tagalog, no, or in Filipino, was Father Pedro Casanas, also a native person of Calamba and was a close friend of Rizal family. So, gaya ng sa akin, also as a Christian, meron din akong parang, what do you call this, parang baptismal certificate. Also, Rizal has also a baptismal certificate and it is read as follows. I, the undersigned parish priest, certify that from the investigation with proper authority for replacing the parish books which were burned September 28, 1862 to be found in docket number 1 of baptism page 49, it appears to be sworn testimony of competent witnesses that Jose Rizal Mercado, in the legitimate son and of lawful wedlock of Don Francisco Rizal Mercado and Doña Teodora Rialonda, having been baptized in this parish of the 22nd of June in the year 1861 by the parish priest Reverend Rufino Colyantes, Reverend Pedro Casanas, being his godfather, witness my signature. So signed by Leoncio Lopez. Moving on, the unusually big head of Jose Rizal was considered to be a good omen, meaning parang swerte daw kasi nga malaki yung ulo. But not to the extent na parang hydrocephalus na siya, ha. So it's just a normal big head. Even the one who baptized Dr. Jose P. Rizal na si Father Rufino Colyantes, even highly impressed dahil sa laki ng ulo daw nito, because he said, and I quote, na take good care of this child for someday will become a good man. So yun yung sabi niya. In addition to that, one of the books I read, sinabi dun doon na see to it na hindi mapapaano yung ulo ni Jose Rizal. Kasi in the future, ito daw yung magiging best asset niya. So as we all know naman, nagkatotoo yung sinabi ni Father Rufino Colyantes, no? So paglaki ni Dr. Jose Rizal, he became physician, no? Specifically ophthalmic surgeon, poet, dramatist, essayist, novelist, historian, painter, sculptor, educator, linguist, musician, naturalist, ethnologist, surveyor, engineer, farmer, businessman, economist, geographer, cartographer, bibliophile, philologist, grammarian, folklorist, philosopher, translator, magician, inventor, humorist, satirist, sportsmen and a lot of more, no? Napakarami. So, see, ang dami, diba? Truly an inspiration here in our country, the Philippines. Truly an inspiration for the young one, tayo, mga estudyante. Ika nga, ang kanyang quote, ang kabataan, ang pag-asa ng bayan. So, I can say, the life of Jose Rizal is very useful, no? He dedicated it to the glory of God, the welfare of our country, you know, freedom, and the voice of those oppressed people. And as I have said a while ago, Rizal lived for only 35 years, no? In such a short period of life, he had accomplished what many men can never achieve kahit na mamuhay for thousands of years, no? I don't think everyone would agree. So more than that, he is our national hero and a political martyr. Just want to have a quick add up, nung isinilang si Dr. Jose P. Rizal, ayun din yung time ng pamumuno ni Governor General Jose Lemery, the one who dispatched some of the powerful Moro in Mindanao as well as Sultan Pululan of Sulu, no? So dahil lang sa, you know, parang nagiging friendly or yung kumakaibigan lang sila sa British Consul. So much for that. So let's proceed to Rizal Parents. Rizal Parents. So, meron isang libro, namely Jose Rizal the Genius. It stated there that Rizal's parents were not that intelligent or genius just like Jose Rizal. But that doesn't mean they were not educated. So, edukado ang mga nanay at tatay ni Jose Rizal. Kasi nga, nakapag-aral ito sa Kolehiyo ng Manila, no? Way back during their younger years. So much for the introduction. Now, let's discuss his father. So, ang pangalan ng papa ni Dr. Jose P. Rizal ay Francisco Mercado Rizal. So, in early manhood, nung namatay ang parents ni Francisco Rizal, no, yung lolo at lola ni Jose Rizal, sinasabing lumipat or he moved to Calamba, and that was when he became a prosperous farmer. So, ayun, no, isang wagsasaka nangungupahan ang papa ni Jose Rizal sa isang Dominican-owned hacienda. So, this father of Jose Rizal was a brave, quiet, and independent-minded man. So, parang doon naman na ni Jose Rizal ang side ng pagiging tahimik niya, no, sa kanyang ama. So, para sa ating national hero, tinatawag niya ang kanyang ama na model of fathers. And lastly, Francisco died in Manila on January 5, 1898 at the age of 80. Ngayon naman ay ang mother ni Jose Rizal. So, his mother's name is Teodora Alonzo Rielonda. She was born on November 8, 1826 in Manila and died on August 16, 1911 at the age of 85. So this mother of Jose Rizal was like an eye catcher during her days, no, at Santa Rosa College of Manila. So she was remarkable for the reason that she possessed refined culture, literary talent, and a business-minded woman. So from her, Jose Rizal inherited his love for books, no, and talent for literature. So, sinasabi ni Jose Rizal din, and I quote, "My mother is a woman of more than ordinary culture. She knows literature and speaks Spanish better than I. She corrected my poems and gave me a good advice when I was studying rhetoric. She is a mathematician and has read many books." So, yun yung sinabi ni Dr. Jose Rizal sa kaniyang ina, no? So, nung tumanda na siya at before pa siya mamatay, the Philippine government offered her a life pension, but she courteously rejected this offer, saying, and I quote, "My family has plenty of, my family has never been patriotic for money. If the government has plenty of funds and does not know what to do with them, better reduce the taxes." So, see, no, how great Dr. Jose Rizal's mother's was, no? And now, let's move on to Rizal's children. So, we are going to determine the names, the year they're born and died, and etc. So, they were 11, no? 9 girls and 2 boys, so including Jose Rizal. So Rizal's children in order of their ages were as follows. Si Saturnina, or also known as Neneng, no? Born in the year 1850 and died in the year 1913. Married to Manuel T. Hidalgo of Tamaron, Batangas, no? She was the eldest of the Rizal's children. Next to this is Pasiano, born in the year 1851 and died in the year 1930. Joined Philippine Revolution after Rizal's after Jose Rizal's execution. Retired to his farm in Los Baños. Bachelor at the age of 79. Ibig sabihin ng bachelor yung parang hindi nagkaasawa, no? Had 2 children, isang babae at isang lalaki kay sa kanyang mistress, Serenina De Sena. So third to this is Narcisa. Ang kanyang palayaw ay Sisa, born in the year 1852 and died in the year 1930. So married to Antonio Lopez. So fourth, we have here Olympia or Ipia, 1855, pinanganak, tapos namatay siya noong 1887, no? Married to Silvestre Ubaldo. Then fifth, we have here Lucia, no? Born in the year 1857 and died in the year 1919. So married to Mariano Herbosa of Manila. So pang-anim naman dito sa kanila magkakapatid ay si Maria, o ang kanyang palayaw ay Biang, no? Born in the year 1859 and died in the year 1945. Married to Daniel Faustino Cruz of Binian, Laguna. So ang pangpito naman, ito na yung ating national hero, si Jose Rizal, no? Born in the year 1861 and died in the year 1896. Live and married to Josephine Bracken, no? Irish girl from Hong Kong. So of course, as we all know, Jose Rizal was our greatest hero and genius. So ang pangwalo naman dito ay si Concepcion or si Concha. So born in the year 1862 and died in the year 1865. So clearly nabuhay lamang siya ng 3 years, no? So it is considered as yun yung first sorrow ni Dr. Jose P. Rizal. So next to this is si Josefa or si Pangoy, born in the year 1865 and died in the year 1945. So she died an old maid at the age of 80. So ibig sabihin wala siya nagkaasawa, no? Parang ulay ba? Ay, ano taon to? Matandang dalaga. So pang-sampo dito ay si Trinidad or si Trining. So born in the year 1868 and died in the year 1951. So gaya kay Josefa, namatay din si Trinidad na matandang dalaga, walang anak, walang asawa. So lastly, ang pinakabata sa ang pinakabunso, no? Ang bunso nila ay si Soledad or si Choleng. Namuhay, pinanganak siya noong 1870 at namatay noong 1921. So clearly the youngest of the Rizal's children and married to Pantelion Quintero of Calamba. Basically, ang sibling relationship ng Rizal family ay affectionately cordial. Meaning, merong love, may respect, at may magagandang treatment ang ibinibigay ng bawat isa, no? Nung lumaki sila, tinatawag ni Jose Rizal ang mga kapatid niyang babae na senyorita at senyora. Senyorita, pagdalaga, like Senyora Josefa and Senyora, yun, no? And senyora naman pagkasal na, like Senyora Saturnina, parang ganun, no? So tapos doon naman sa kaisa-isang kapatid na lalaki ni Jose Rizal na si Pasiano ay like he treated Pasiano more than like a brother, no? Parang tinatrato niya na din na parang tatay si Pasiano. So the respect, the value that Jose Rizal gave to his older brother was something like beyond compare. Parang ganun, no? He even immortalized Pasiano in his famous novel, No Limit Tangere, no? As wise philosopher Tasio. So, sinabi pa nga niya na kahit ang kapatid niya ay Indio, you all know naman kung ano yung Indio. Indio, tinatawag yun ng mga Kastila sa atin na parang, di ba, parang tamad. Yun yung tinatawag nila sa atin dati, Indio. So, sinasabi ni Dr. Jose Rizal na although or kahit na ang kapatid niya ay isang Indio, as what Spanish called as Filipinos way back, as I've said, in Spaniards colonization, Paciano is more generous and noble than all of the Spaniards together. So he tagged and regarded Paciano as the most noble of Filipinos. And also, may isang sulat noong October 12, 1888, where he said, and I quote, "He is much finer and more serious than I am. He is bigger and more slim. He is not so dark. His nose is fine, beautiful, and sharp. But he is bow-legged." Parang ganun.
Well, good day, everyone. Our topic is all about Rizal's ancestry. So just like any other typical Filipino individual, Rizal was a product of mixture of races, which are the Negrito, Indonesian, Malay, Chinese, Japanese, and even Spanish. However, predominantly, he was a Malayan and was a magnificent specimen of Asian manhood. So his great-great-grandfather from his father's side, which is Domingo Lamio, was a Chinese immigrant from the city of Phuket in Chiang Chau, and arrived here, and he arrived here in Manila in the year 1690. Domingo Lamio became a Christian and married a Chinese Christian girl named Ines de la Rosa. So he assumed the surname Mercado in the year 1731, which is very appropriate for him because he is a merchant. So the Spanish term Mercado means market in English. Domingo Mercado and Ines de la Rosa had a son, which is Francisco Mercado, who resided in Binian and he is elected as the governor silly or the municipal mayor of the town. He also married a Chinese Filipino mestiza, which is Cirilla Bernacha, and one of their sons is Juan Mercado, which is the grandfather of Rizal, who also married the Chinese Filipino mestiza, which is Cirilla Alejandro. In addition to that, Juan Mercado also became a gobernadorcillo of the town. So they had 13 children, and one of them is Francisco Mercado, which is the father of Rizal. At the age of 8, Francisco Mercado lost his father. So basically, lumaki siya, nakasama niya yung kanyang ina. He studied Latin and philosophy in the College of San Jose in Manila. So while studying, doon niya na-meet si Chodora Alonso Rialonda, which is the mother of Rizal. So si Chodora is a college student from College of Santa Rosa. So they got married, they fall in love, and basically they got married. So after that, they settled down in Calamba, and that's where they engaged in farming and business, and doon na rin nila binuo yung kanilang pamilya. It is believed that Doña Chidora's family descended from Lacandula, which is known as the last native king of Tondong. Her great-grandfather, or Rizal's maternal great-great-grandfather, which is Eugenio Rizua, married a Filipina named Benigna. So their daughter Regina married Manuel de Quintos, a Chinese Filipino lawyer from Pangasinan. So one of the daughters of attorney Quintos and Regina is Brigida, who married Lorenzo Alberto Alonso, which is a prominent Spanish Filipino mestizo from Binian. So their children were Narcisa, Chidora, which is the mother of Rizal, Gregorio, Manuel, and Jose. The next topic is the surname of Rizal. So the real surname of Rizal's family was Mercado, which was adopted in the year 1731 by Domingo Lamco, or the great-great-grandfather of Dr. Jose Rizal. He is known as a full-blooded Chinese. So the Rizal family acquired a second surname, which is the Rizal, because of their family friend, who was then the Spanish alcalde de mayor, or the provincial governor of Laguna. And then it is said in the letter of Dr. Jose Rizal to his friend Blumenrit, he said that in a non-verbatim manner that siya lang daw yung nag-iisang Rizal sa kanilang pamilya, because his family still preferred to use their old surname, which is the Mercado. In fact, Mercado to talaga yung kuan, yung talaga yung all yung surname nila. But then sa dami ng Mercado sa family na sa Pilipinas na hindi related sa kanila, binigyan sila nung nung family friend nila na isang alcalde mayor ng Rizal na surname. But then yung parents niya hindi masyadong nagput ng attention doon. So he has to use it but it seems like yung kinalabasan niya is naging illegitimate son siya kasi nga siya lang gumamit ng Rizal. So the next topic is the Rizal home. So the house of the Rizal family, basically where the hero was born, was one of the distinguished stone houses in Calamba during the Spanish time. So it is a two-story building, rectangular in shape, and it is made out of adobe stones and hardwoods. Then yung roof niya is naka-red tiles. So dinescribe ni Dr. Rafael Palma yung house nila Rizal as a yun na nga, high and solid and sumptuous. Then yung house structure is earthquake proof. Then yung mga sliding windows is tinatawag na sliding shell windows. And then yun na nga, yung first floor is stone bounded, however the second floor it is made out of entirely of wood except nga dun sa atit nila, which is red tile. Then yung merong part ng bahay na kapag umuulan is may sumasalo ng tubig for home use. Since sinabi kanina na parents ni Rizal is nag-engage into farming and business, behind their house was a yard full of turkeys and chickens and a big garden of tropical fruit trees just like atis, balimbing, magkopa, papaya, santol, and etc. So the family, the Rizal's family belonged to the Principalia or the noble class during the rulings of Spaniard in the Philippines. Their family was one of the distinguished families in Calamba. Dahil na rin sa sipag at syaga, Rizal's parents were able to live well. So from the farms, which were all rented from the Dominican Order, they harvested rice, corn, and sugarcane. They also raise pigs, chicken, and turkeys in their backyard. So, sorry about that. Aside from farming and stock raising, the mother of Rizal, which is Doña Chadora, managed a general goods store, a small flour mill, and even a homemade ham press. As an evidence of their affluence, Rizal's parents were able to build a large stone house which is situated near the church and to buy another one. So, may nag-own din sila ng isang carriage which was a status symbol for the Ilustrados during the Spanish Philippines and a private library which is the largest in Calamba, which is consisted of more than 1,000 volumes. So, they sent their children in colleges in Manila. So, with a combination of affluence and culture, hospitality and courtesy, they prominently attend in all different social and religious affairs in the community. Kilala rin sila bilang isang gracious host to their guests and visitors, whether it is a friar, Spanish officials, and even to their Filipino friends. So, during the town fiestas and other holidays, beneath their roof, all people, irrespective of their color, rank, social position, and even their economic status were welcome. Gaya ng isang typical na pamilya, the Rizal had a simple, contented, and happy life. So, in consonance with the Filipino custom, the family ties among the Rizals were intimately close. Don Francisco and Doña Chidora loved their children so much. However, they never got to spoil them. In fact, they were strict parents and they trained their children to love God, to behave well, to be obedient, to respect others, especially the old folks. So, every time na nagkakamali yung mga anak nila, even si Jose Rizal, is nakakatanggap sila ng palo galing sa kanilang parents. So, evidently, they believe in the maxim, spare the rod and spoil the child. Every day, the Rizal heard mass in town during, especially during Sundays and Christian holidays. They prayed together daily at home, for example, yung Angelus during the sunset and the rosary before retiring to bed at night. So after the family prayers, all the children kissed the hands of their parents. So life was not, however, all prayers and church services for the Rizal children. So yung si Jose Rizal at yung mga kapatid niya is nibigyan ng ample time and freedom by their strict and religious parents. So they are allowed to play in the azotea or in the garden by themselves. So yung mga matatanda sa mga kapatid is pinapayagan din na makipaglaro sa mga anak ng ibang pamilya.
Thank you for watching.